welcome to my studio.
As you can see, there are multiple wall paintings. This is what I am going to show you today. I'm going to show you how I create the beautiful koi fish, and actually you will be able to learn this through a workshop. It's a one-day workshop to wet felt koi fish, but I'm showing some results before and you can get an idea how it works. So this is the koi fish. This one actually is the actual samples of work that I'm going to demonstrate today. And during the workshop, you will also see the step-by-step and learning how to create them using the beautiful merino wool and mulberry silk by wet felting. So the wet felting is combining different color wool and then adding water and soap, and we turn them into felt fabric. It's an ancient technique to create stiff fabric by hand. And this seaweed is a little bit pop up. I added later on when it was dried. So this was created with needle felting technique. Besides wet felting and needle felting, we have another felting technique we call the nuno felting technique, like this larger piece. So this piece was done previously during the flat out under pressure. It's a 24 hours challenge last June. So I went big because it was a virtual exhibition. So I'm using wool to create my koi fish. So this was my original work, my first koi fish. And I combined with social form. So nuno felting, the nuno word is a Japanese word mean fabric. So this is how we combining fabrics, silk chiffon in this case, and it's see-through, and I adding a light layers of merino wool to create my patterns. And there you can see some shines from the mulberry silk. So this is all by nuno felting. And with the same technique, I can also create scarf. So this is the silk chiffon that I add with some merino wool to create different patterns. So you can also learn this in another workshops. But today I'm going to show you the samples of how to create this beautiful koi fish. And also I have other 5-week class that you can learn all different basics of felting, like needle felting, wet felting, whether it is in two-dimensional like a painting or three-dimensional structure. And sometimes when we create felt, it's not only for decorative, it can be functional. So like felt soap or dryer ball, there are a lot of different things can be created through creating with natural wool fiber.